Okay then, Joe, thank you very much for meeting me today. I'm with the County Choir. We're doing quite a lot of interviews. I've interviewed Michael Flynn before, obviously just in Edinburgh, and now you've been the choice of our committee, you know, to be the next person to interview. So thanks for meeting me today. First question I got, what were you hoping to gain from your loan move when you came to the new board?
First and foremost, I felt I've come to the point in my career where I needed to play games. And I also knew my contract with Peterborough was up at the end of the season. And I fully felt this season I really needed to go get a run of games. And knowing Justin here at Newport and first hearing of the opportunity to come here, I knew I needed to go do that.
Yeah. You played under Justin for Russian and Diamonds, am I correct there?
Yes, I did, yeah.
Yeah. So obviously there's a lot of players here who obviously part of that team. Did that make it easier for you to come here on the loan?
It was a factor. I mean, working with Justin before at Rushden, I thoroughly enjoyed working with him, and I think everyone who said he's worked with Justin before really like him as a manager. So knowing he was, you know, the gaffer here, it made it an easy decision to come.
Great. Were you frustrated with your lack of game time then at Peterborough?
Yeah, it was very frustrating. For any player to be on a bench for, you know, I was there for nearly four years and very limited game time. And you find yourself when you're on the bench that often, and you maybe feel like you lose a little bit of self-belief, and you want to play, you train well, but it's like training, you're doing all the training, but you're not. It's not for anything. It feels like it's not for anything almost. So
when you're working hard towards something and it's just not being shown off or appreciated.
Yeah. You know, yeah.
Feel that. Did Connor Washington advise you on a move here by any chance? Because that's something that a lot of people have asked me.
Well, I hadn't spoke to him whilst I was on loan here, but obviously I had to return for December because of the loan window and the rest of it. But when I spoke to him, he said he thoroughly enjoyed his time here. And well, to be fair, when I'd gone back, me and Justin had already agreed. Well, I certainly agreed my side of it, personal terms, to come back. So I was just hoping the two clubs could sort it. So right, he didn't advise me on it, I wouldn't say, but no, he spoke highly of Newport and vice versa.
And so it obviously helps along the way, I suppose.
Yes, yeah, exactly.
Fantastic. So how do you feel your loan spell actually went while you were here?
Extremely well, from a personal view and for the team, I felt. But I was very happy with my personal performances, and the team was on a great run. And we've come off it, I feel, a little bit lately. Everyone's not going so well since Justin's left, or since the speculation started anyway. But we've still picked up a few points lately, so we're hoping we'll get that form back from the autumn sort of time. But no, I was really pleased with the loan.
Because a lot of fans have been very vocal about, you know, your contribution to the team, you know, especially during your loan spell. A lot of them have actually said that your performances could well be the difference between us being in a promotion push and a relegation battle. So how would you respond to that then?
Oh, I don't know much about that, but it's nice to have that feedback. But I'm a team player. I think it's the whole team, you know. You need players performing in front of you for me to be able to perform well. You know, it's like a knock-on effect, if you like.
Yeah, definitely.
If one player is having a great game, it spurs on everyone else. And I felt when I was on loan here, I was playing well, but I felt the other lads were playing well in front of me, and that helped me play well.
Excellent. So, was a permanent move here a hard decision to make?
No, it was easy. It was easy. As soon as I had my loan spell here, thoroughly enjoyed the environment, and enjoyed playing here, and obviously having the chance and opportunity to play a consistent level of games was, you know, I bit the hand off, so was very eager to make it happen.
Okay, what is your opinion of Newport supporters, and what is it like to play at Ronnie Parade?
Very, very passionate fans, I feel. They've always been very positive towards me and supportive of me since I've walked in the door. And I think at Romney Parade as well. I think we've made it a bit of a fortress this year. I mean, that reflects, I feel, we've had very good home form. I think we've only lost 3 games at home all year.
I think that's right.
So that bodes well for home performances. Mm-hmm. So I think us as a team, and me certainly, really enjoy playing at Romney Parade.
Justin Edinburgh brought you here to the club. Yeah. How do you feel about his departure?
Same as everyone else, I think. We're all gutted that he left, but it's football. Mm-hmm. Justin had a very successful spell here. It's like players, if you're playing well, other teams can come in for you. So I think it's the same as managers. Mm-hmm. He's obviously been very successful, and I think he's deserved that chance at a higher level. But it's football, like I say, we all move on. And I'm pleased for him. But also feel a bit gutted that he's left from a personal point of view. But you know, we'll get on with it.
Yeah, as you say, that's football, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay. How do you envisage the club's future under Jimmy Dack?
Positive. Mm-hmm. Positive. Dack is a real positive character, and he lifts everyone up in training and in the building. And I just see a positive future. I think he's definitely the right man to take us forwards from now. And I think all the players will give 100% for him.
Excellent. Hey, not too many left now. Can we go up this year, in your opinion?
Absolutely, absolutely. Yeah. We've put ourselves in a great position. I know we've dropped off it a little bit lately, but I don't see any reason why we won't regain a good run of form. I think this league, all you need is a little run of games, and then we'll be right back up there. And I feel that's just around the corner. I think with the way training's been since Dacky's taken over, really positive, and it's just trying to, you know, get that little bit, the final third on the pitch now to start scoring a few more goals. And I feel that's around the corner, and I definitely think promotion is possible.
Obviously with Jimmy now being actually appointed as manager for the rest of the season, I'd imagine that allows everybody to settle a bit, you know, there's no uncertainty surrounding anything.
Yeah, it's a bit of clarification. Everyone knows the situation now, so you can't use that as an excuse. I think he's definitely the man we all wanted, so we'll all get our heads down, and you know, we all know our aims at playoffs, so I think we can do it.
Excellent. Okay, who's the best player you played with and the best player you played against?
Best player I've played with, I think, is George Boyd. He's technical, brilliant, but also his professionalism, just on the training pitch, on the match pitch, and off the pitch as well, away from there, he's just brilliant. And when, as a young player, when I was at Peterborough with him, I was 20 when I walked in the door there, and seeing that first team player who's technically that good, but also got that high level of professionalism, really helps. Play against Shay Given. I played against Shay Given in a pre-season friendly, and as a goalkeeper to goalkeeper, I've rated him, always rated him, so.
I've always rated him.
Yeah,
one of the best.
He's had a great career. Yeah.
One of the best in the Premier League that I've seen.
Yeah.
Okay. Who's your best friend here at Newport?
Probably Jamie Stevens. Mm-hmm. Goalkeepers. We train together a lot, and the goalkeeper union's strong. Mm-hmm. So I think goalkeepers have an extra special bond. We train together a lot. We know the situation of being a goalkeeper. It can be lonely at times. It can be. Feel a bit vulnerable, so we're always there for each other. So I think that's why goalkeepers tend to bond well.
Who's your boyhood team? Who's your favourite player growing up? And who would you say is your biggest professional mentor?
My boyhood team is Brighton Hove Albion, my local team. I'm from Brighton, so I always supported them from a young age.
Well, you're not too happy to see us not going to make the League Cup.
No, I wasn't. That didn't affect me coming in.
That's not. Sorry. Your favourite player growing up?
For me, I always looked at David Seaman as an ideal goalkeeper. I think probably because he was the England number one as well. And I just really liked his style of play. I think he's a very traditional goalkeeper. Quite a textbook goalkeeper, whereas if you look at Schmeichel, he was a bit more unorthodox, I think. But I really looked at the sort of the textbook goalkeeper like David Seaman. So, he was my favourite player growing up. Sorry, what's the last one?
The last one was your biggest professional mentor.
Biggest professional mentor. I've been pretty lucky in my career so far. I've always had a good goalkeeper coach for me to be sort of my professional mentor. But one that sticks out for me is Kevin Shoemake, who was my goalkeeper coach when I first went to Rushden Diamonds when I was 16. I'd just been let go by Crystal Palace, and he sort of took me under his wing there. And even now, I seek to advice with him, and I speak to him every week, and he's always helped me. So he's pretty much my mentor.
Excellent. Well, then that's all. Thanks very much for seeing
me. My pleasure. Nice one.
Thanks all for watching. Cheers for that, guys.
Cheers.